Moin Denison asserts its instant noodles are safe to eat after several countries ordered a recall of its or some of its products. It says it does not use ethylene oxide, the chemical cited in the ongoing recall of their instant noodles in the European Union and Taiwan. But it did acknowledge that when used as a treatment for agricultural products, traces of the chemical may still show in processed seasoning and sauces. Moin Denison also assures customers or consumers Lakmé products in the Philippines are registered with the Food and Drug Administration. Local health officials, meanwhile, vow to investigate the matter.
We have a process, no? Kapag gumagawa tayo ng investigasyon regarding discontaminated na mga produkto like food, no? Merong specific batches at saka lot numbers yung pong mga apektadong nakikita natin. So kung ano man po ang matagpuan ng ating Food and Drug Administration na talagang with the presence of this specific component or chemical, yun lang po yung tatanggalin sa merkado dahil yun po yung mga apektado.
Moin Denison shares tank on Thursday following news of the product recall in some countries. Shares of the food giant slumped 7%, one of the worst performers for the day.
Philippine government data show nearly 3 million Filipinos were jobless in May. The latest jobs figures also pointed to a rise in underemployment. More from Jackie Pascual.
The Philippine unemployment rose to 6% in May from 5.7% in April. This translates to 2.93 million Filipinos without a job. The Philippine Statistics Authority says the figure is much lower than last year's 7.7%, but is still above pre-pandemic level.
Pababa naman talaga yung ating unemployment rate, but still higher compared to the pre-pandemic level of 2019, kung saan yung baseline natin doon ay nasa 5.1%.
The PSA says opening up the economy has led to more jobs compared to last year, but there was a drop in jobs in many sectors due to the ongoing pandemic. And one of the casualties is the education sector.
Primary elementary education for children without special needs, may bawas tayo ng 104,000. At yung pangalawa, yung pre-primary preschool education for children without special needs, may bawas tayo ng 103,000.
The executive director of a school in Mandaluyong asserts many schools have closed down either temporarily or permanently.
Maraming mga employees, both teaching and non-teaching staff, na nawalan ng trabaho.
The Labor Department was not surprised with the PSA figures, saying there were a lot of unemployed because many just graduated in May. Labor Secretary Bienvenido Laguesma notes another cause for concern is the underemployment rate, which rose to 14.5% in May.
Yung challenge na ano, yung sa underemployment, kasi that means quality of employment remains to be an issue, a challenge for us.
The labor chief says he is in talks with various government agencies as well as the private sector to improve the skills of Filipinos.
We are now reviewing and finalizing yung labor and employment plan for the year 2022 to 2028. Lahat ng departments may kinalaman sa buhay ng manggagawa at kanilang pamilya, magtulong-tulong.
The National Economic and Development Authority says they are pushing for job creation by improving quality of education and skills training. Schools are also optimistic the return of face-to-face classes will generate more jobs. Government is hopeful they can add not just additional jobs, but quality employment. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine peso slides further against the U.S. dollar. The local currency closed at 56.06 against the greenback on Thursday. This marks its weakest showing in nearly 17 years or since September 2005. A weak peso means the country has to pay more for its imports, such as oil and food. The Philippine Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla earlier downplayed the depreciation of the currency, saying it was caused by the strengthening of the U.S. dollar. But he also said the central bank would participate in the market to address excessive short-term volatility.
The gross international reserves of the Philippines dropped in June. It settled at $101.9 billion, a 22-month low and down from May's 103.65 billion. The Philippine Central Bank said the decrease mainly reflected the national government's payments of its foreign currency debt obligations and the downward adjustment in the value of the BSP's gold holdings. Despite the decline, the BSP says the current dollar stockpile level represents a more than adequate external liquidity buffer, equivalent to more than 8 months' worth of imports of goods and payments of services. The country's GIR has been declining since it peaked at $110.12 billion at the end of 2020.